Kotter, tomorrow on ABC.
Hi, this is Steve Edwards. One of the things that we'll be discussing this morning on AM Chicago is what is known as the single scenes or single bars, which will be much popularized by the opening of the movie Looking for Mr. Goodbar. Now, there's a big single scenes here in Chicago, and the questions that we are going to be asking is the single scene when a boy goes to meet a girl. Boy meets girl in a bar. Is it fun? Is it a good time for all? Is it just a quick sexual encounter? Does something meaningful develop from it? Or is there really a lot of loneliness and desperation and sadness? We'll be talking to the habitués of the single scene here in Chicago this morning and be finding out about that. Also on the show today, we are bringing to you, I think, one of the high points of the AM Chicago show in 2¾ years on the air. We were supposed to have 5 of them. 3 of them have staggered in this morning. The finalists of the Male Macho Contest. Yay! We will have some of the most macho guys in Chicago here. Anything else this morning? We'll find out. Join us in a moment on AM Chicago.
What a beautiful fur. What animal is it from?
Man, it's a $98 fake fur. Now just $77 at William A. Lewis.
We French did not invent wine, but we made it an art. We did not invent love, but we made it more romantic. We did not invent fragrances, but we made them more elegant, more sensual. We created Infini. Infini. Elegant, sensual, very, very French. Infini, the most elegantly sensual of all French fragrances.
At Carson's, most stores.
Some men steal gold, some men steal hearts. The man from Lisbon stole a country. In one dazzling year, he made himself the richest, most powerful man in Europe. He stole Portugal. The man from Lisbon. His story is true. The brilliant war of wits, the irresistible love that tears him from his family. And this novel about him is truly the great new best-selling adventure. The Man from Lisbon by Thomas Gifford. Soon to be a major motion picture. At your bookstore from McGraw-Hill Book Company.
Support the Chicago Urban League. Good morning. It's AM Chicago starring Steve Edwards with Sandi Freeman. And now, here's Steve.
Good morning. I'm Mr. Goodbar.
And I've been looking for you.
I must tell you something that we're doing here. As you know, if you were watching yesterday, we want very much to get Prince Charles on the show. He's in town on a visit.
He arrived yesterday afternoon.
And we've been asking everybody we know
to please get him on the show.
If they knew Prince Charles and mm-hmm. could they talk to him today. He does have a busy schedule. I am told at this point that we have a pretty good shot that Prince Charles will be here probably later on in the show. He's not here right now, but later on in the show, he is going to take time out from his royal visits here in Chicago and stop by. So we may be getting I hope so. I'd be really excited.
Bonnie Prince Charles right here.
The truth of the matter is, you know that it's not that I'm jaded. I love doing the show and meeting the people and the stars and the people involved in the issues of the day.
Absolutely.
But, you know, I'm not exactly awed.
This would be a thrill. Yeah.
This, I would be awed.
I agree.
Something
I would be too.
Something I'd be looking forward to would be to meet Prince Charles. And I really do want to meet him this morning. We have a letter before we get into anything else here that I want to read.
All right.
This may go on. Well, I'll read it to you. I won't categorize it. I'll just read it to you. And why don't you hold this thing here so I can...
Yes, I'd be happy to.
Just hold.
Hold that.
Thank
okay,
you
fine. I have it.
Let me hold this too.
Hold that also. Hold okay, it. Thank you. I have it, I think.
Dear Mr. Edwards, confession. This is an unabashed fan letter. Admission. It begins with a cliche. I have never before written a fan letter. What moves me now to conjure up adjectives sufficient to express the unbounded enthusiasm which makes such a letter? Gosh, Mr. Edwards, you are wonderful, and Sandy is neat. But that stage manager of yours is dynamite. He lends sparkle, charm, and joie de vivre to what is surely Channel 7's best local live morning show. When this fellow appears on the screen, magic happens. I feel less self-conscious about the amusing dimensions of my own ample figure. All stylish stouts in my neighborhood join with me in saluting you for presenting this impishly delightful troll. TV's greatest discovery of the season, our new idol, Herman Fell. That's not all, Herman. Herman knew nothing about this. He's
absolutely
being very cool.
Nothing.
You're being very good about it, Herman. That's not all. I'm going to continue the letter. Would it be possible for your staff to send me an 8x10 Hollywood type glossy suitable for framing of your talented new star? Not for me, you understand, but for my niece. And we have. Here it is. The Herman Fell 8x10 glossy.
And Herman's going to autograph it.
He will autograph
it. He will autograph this and send it out to
We'll find another one for the State Lake. All right. And it says, yours faithfully, and then it said, Herman's biggest fan, Bob Gibson, who lives in Belvedere. And this is true. No put on, Herman. Herman, I have never gotten a letter like that.